If you're like me, you can't dance, but whatever. I'm just gonna shake, 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 shake it up, shake it up. Hello there, dancing machines. Julian here for D News, and I'm a firm believer that everyone should march to the beat of their own drum. As it turns out, though, it may be physically impossible for some people to keep a beat. Researchers at McGill University and the University of Montreal recently published a study comparing two people with two metaphorical left feet to 32 controls. They had all of them clap out a beat of their own, then keep pace with a metronome, and finally clap along with a metronome while it changed tempos randomly. At first, nobody had a problem. While everyone kept their own beat or followed a steady metronome, they all had to clap. This rules out the possibility that there was something wrong with their motor functions. But when the two tuneless souls had to keep time with a changing rhythm, they were hopeless. And I don't mean they were just clapping on the one and the three beats like a little old lady in church. I mean they couldn't swap to the new tempo like everyone else could after just a few beats. They would try, but they would be off the new beat by big gaps. They were certified beat deaf. There's no explanation yet for why some people have rhythm and some people don't, but the hypothesis is something's off with their biological rhythms. We all have biological rhythms, like your heartbeat and your day-night cycle. Even the way you talk has a rhythm to it. But apparently, for some people, they just aren't able to adjust their rhythms based on external cues. Now, before you use it as an excuse to avoid the dance floor, it's an extremely rare condition. One previous study at the International Laboratory for Brain, Music, and Sound Research in Montreal interviewed dozens of volunteers who claimed they couldn't keep a beat and only found one qualified test subject. Mathieu Dion was the unlucky soul, and at one point in his life, he actually was a mascot at an amusement park who had to dance in shows as part of his job. Eventually, they just stuck him in the back so he could copy his fellow dancers, but it probably helped that no one could see him too. The study had him dance to a variety of music, because scientists are cruel. They found the only genre he could keep up with was techno because it had a loud, steady pulse. Dion had a good attitude about it, saying, "I'm the first diagnosed in the world of having no rhythm, which is something great." Way to stay upbeat, Mathieu. Even if you're beat deaf, I say you just go for it. You do you. Dance like nobody's watching, even though everybody's watching. Shame on them. You have a condition. Aside from making you feel awesome and chasing your cares away, dancing might have some other cool side effects. Crystal's got the deets on the beats over here. Are you afraid of busting a move? Would finding out that you're beat deaf give you more confidence or make you find a different hobby? Let us know in your comments, and I'll see you next time on D News.